Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with... Someone get that bloody... Get that. Could you get... Could someone... Could you pick that? Fine, I'll get it myself. But yes. Overlord 2 is what we're here with some more of. Let's just see if... Did they have anything? Was there anything worth? No? Fine. I mean, honestly, I wasn't expecting them to be carrying too many armaments. I wouldn't be surprised if the only swords they brought were the swords they were carrying. I would also not be surprised if those swords were really bad. Oh no! The seals have brought reinforcements! Woe is me! Ah, truly a terrifying force. Truly. Just an army that will strike fear into the heart. Thank you. Onwards we really slowly waddle. An army held down only by the sheer lack of speed of its general. Can't I be like 3 miles behind the lines of this fight? Like, hoping to move my drinks cabinet a couple of feet closer to Berlin? No, this isn't a World War I game. Isn't it? Really? I thought this was roughly the level of the Austro-Hungarian army. Not funny. Just making random jokes about... Random vague history jokes. Don't care, really. Do what I like, you can't stop me. Is there any reason for me to go round? I literally just went round to pick up a pitchfork, didn't I? Eh, whatever. It's slightly better equipment than what they're carrying anyway. Though I do question whether or not a pitchfork held in one hand would be a better weapon than a club. I mean, yeah, I can stab a guy, but one-handed held by a midget? Destroy! Destroy! Apparently they are reproducing faster than we can kill them, which is frankly impressive. Again, I do wonder whether or not hunters in this game are, again, their own separate species, given the fact that they appear to be birthed, fully formed, wearing wool. Unless that unless it turns out the hunters are just born wearing wool. So they're not actually wearing wool, it's just a clever disguise. It's actually just their fur. I mean, apparently I was born with fucking a rag around my face and glowing yellow eyes, so the all fucking bets are off today, lads. Got no idea how things work anymore.
Do you remember that place, sire?
I believe I tried to burn it down.
The sleepy, snowy little town that was going to hand you over to the Empire.
Technically, they did hand me over to the Empire, it's just the Empire was entirely too, what's the word I'm thinking? Stupid, that was it. The Empire is entirely too fucking stupid to actually capture a child. I mean, I get it, I had reinforcements, but let's be honest, the minions aren't great. The minions are not the optimal solution. Honestly, I think the optimal solution would probably be a bunch of mercs, really. Mercenaries, rather than these fucking things. Because these things are eternally loyal and I don't have to pay them. And it makes you wonder what their motivation is. Well, they're just kind of an elemental force of evil that just has to follow the biggest douchebag in the room. But I haven't said that. There's always... That's actually one thing that a lot of people commented, and indeed I agree, that this game handles a lot better than Overlord 1, is the whole actually being evil thing. Whereas Overlord 1, you were basically kind of neutral but ambitious, or a dick. Like, those were your two choices. In this one, it's a dick or more of a dick. Or, like, a different kind of dick. Like, I think it's like you're a dick either way, but it's like you are destructive or corruptive in this game, as opposed to... as opposed to, you know, just neutral or a dick, which I always preferred. But even still, the Glorious Empire is somehow more of a dick than you most of the time, which is impressive. Good's incompetent, and the closest thing to a large-scale good guy villain, a good guy army, it's still dicks.
He's not looking quite so gentle anymore. In fact, he looks rather peeved.
not even pissed off at me this whole fucking time. So I'm just gonna wipe out these elves. These elves are not a threat to me. I am not gonna sweat these guys. Attack in as limp-wristed and hippie-like a fashion as you can, man. Whatever you do, don't hurt them more than you have to, man.
You've gone too far this time, man.
This time? How many times have we interacted? All of once. Fuck you, you don't know what too far is. Furthest you've ever been is far out. Ba-da-ba-ba-da-ba-ba. Still not funny? Okay. Now can we... Is he just dead now? No, he doesn't appear to be dead. We appear to have just injured him.
No! No! Stop this at once! This noble beast belongs with us! Come here! Come here, boy! As if we magical folk didn't have enough problems of our own with the Empire without the likes of you trying to expunge us! Now, let us away! Set sail for the sanctuary!
We should follow them, sire. If only we had the swimming abilities of the blue minions. Oh well, it looks like we'll have to find another way into this sanctuary of theirs.
Yeah, they probably left an unguarded cave entrance. I wouldn't worry about it. I mean, they're elves and they're hippies. I mean, how clever could they possibly be? I mean, they did quite literally just, you know.
Freeze gone. Looks like someone has been logging this area, Gloom. I wonder why.
Oh yeah, that's another thing. The minions have names in this game. I think you can actually name them and resurrect specific ones as well. Which is weird. The only reason I could think that you'd want to resurrect a specific minion is if it had a particularly cool bit of kit. Like, I don't know, something. Like, say, like, ah, like, actually.
Creatures! We've got a breach, man! Attack! Attack!
How magical are the minions, really? If we're being honest. Yes, I know. You said it the first time. It must be said, this is probably a fucking comment. You know what? I'm actually going to save this comment until it's more relevant, as opposed to saying it now in reference to something that happened last video, given the fact that it's probably been at least a day since I actually fucking recorded that last video. So what's the uploaded that last video. So what's the point of commenting on it? You know, you'd have to go back and check. I think I'll wait. Gotta love this commentary. I'm commentating about how I'm not gonna do specific commentary.
Your mouse won't follow you into certain areas, sire. And like all primitive beasts, these wolves are afraid of fire.
These wolves are afraid of loading screens. We can't carry them with us through the loading screen. What are you, mad? Why did they take a ship here? Shelby,
do hurry up. I have a warm oil bath and a large plate of quail's eyeballs to attend to.
Of course, Boreas. I thought you'd like to meet some of the brave men who secured the magical creatures from the, area. And these are the lucky ones.
What's up with you, Maximus?
No, I want you to call me
Miss Trixieville Buttercup Fairy.
Are you serious?
And you could all come and visit me when I move
into my mushroom house. SIC, Species Identity Crisis. It's a terrible thing. We have no idea what this is, but it was well guarded.
Well, make sure it doesn't eat anyone, and then bring it to my town hall.
Foolish fat human, that's a spellstone, sire. It unlocks the magical potential of any who possess it. Better not let it fall into Boreas's pudgy hands.
Kind of already has. If I'm being honest. I mean, we did quite literally just watch it get carted away. it has fallen into Boreas' pudgy hands. Well, I suppose technically. I mean, if we're gonna be fucking picky about it, it's not in his hands, but it's in the hands of people who he owns? Gives orders to? Have to obey? I don't know. Pick whichever phrase you think better represents his relationship with his soldiers. I think he thinks he owns them. You gotta love the work ethic of these guys. They managed to set up a barrier facing the wrong way. I mean, they've already seen that there's minions coming at them from the other way, but instead they decide to build the blockade in the way that Boreas clearly went. So Boreas has clearly marched his fat, pudgy asshole through here already. And yet they decide to build the... What, in case he turns coat and tries to attack those two guys? What? There's magic.
Welcome to the sanctuary, creature of magic.
No, do not let this barbarian in, Dryad. He is an enemy to all that is fluffy and adorable, like this poor fellow here.
Don't worry, Lord. I'm sure you'll find a way to bypass. This looks like a shard of Netherworld rock. Perhaps it will become active once the Netherworld accepts you as its true overlord.
Oh, thanks. Give me fucking self-esteem problems.
I don't know what happened here, but their loss is our gain. Quick, pick up that spellstone. As soon as Grubby can build a gate, you can send it back to the Netherworld. Declaring war, or he wants to marry you to his pet dormouse.
Gnome is clearly a difficult language.
That's clearly an act of aggression, sire. It cannot be tolerated. Exterminate those squeakers.
And now we have a mission that will go through the entire game, which I've never managed to complete. Murdering all of the gnomes. Because the gnomes are little thieving bastards. They steal anything that isn't nailed down, as it were, that they can get their little bastard hands on and then try and run away. Grab that, please. Another thing back there, if you can pick that up, lovely. Why send minions after them when you can just whack them? Good question, I think. Come here, lads.
Get that spellstone back to the Netherworld, Dark One.
Just can we just kill these? I saw one. There's one bopping around here. There's the little fucker. Apparently we can't close that. I seem to remember that you could, but apparently I'm remembering incorrectly. Right, onwards we go. Let's just try to ignore the bastard gnomes.
Ah, Nordberg. Nearly 13 winters have passed since you were last there, sire.
Really?
Soon you will return. Once more on the feasting of Midwinter's Eve to finish what you started. Revenge is a dish best served cold and screaming.
Well, I don't think there's any way we could serve it as anything other than cold, given the fact that this place appears to be set in fucking persistent, constant, bloody winter. I mean, it's not just me. This place is perpetually cold, isn't it? One, two, three, four, five. Not gonna waste any more of you on that than I need to. What are you doing? He's carrying a thing. Oh, you little fucks.
Get that spellstone back to the netherworld, Dark One.
We found another thing. Cool. Whatever. I'll take the other thing. I like owning things, especially if I just find these things in the hands of people I don't like. Oh, look. Citizen of Nordberg probably chittering and fucking conspiring about some bullshit.
And Governor Boreas said he wanted stuffed widgeon at the Midwinter's Feast. Well, he said to the wife, what the hell's a widgeon?
Oh, that's posh stuff. I think...
Aha! Grubby has managed to bring you a Netherworld Gate Master. This will allow your minions to transport the spellstone straight to the Netherworld. A command upgrade. You can summon more minions to the battlefield now.
Pretty ornate for one dude, isn't it?
Look at all that evil energy surging into you, Lord. I don't quite know what spell it's unlocked within you, sire. If you run into some townsfolk, do feel free to use them as test subjects.
Sound the alarm! Run for the gates!
Is the local just lighting up to crowd your evil presence spell, sire?
Ah, yes, I remember.
The peons have set fires outside Nordberg to ward off their midwinter's demons. We'll need to find our red minions before we can enter.
Yes, I recall how this spell works. This directly ties into the, as it were, corruption or destruction or domination or destruction system, because you can either... Yeah, do that where you just corrupt that, where you just basically dominate their minds, or you can keep the button pressed down to just outright kill them.
But if you held the spell for longer, you'd have killed them outright. Enslavement or death, domination or destruction. These are the great overlording choices, sire.
Personally, I always play the game as domination rather than destruction. Domination just seems to make a lot more sense. You know, it seems like the most sensible of approaches to me. I mean, why kill a guy if you can actually use him for something? I was gonna say, I could have sworn there was another guy still fucking popping around. Come here! Stop running around, you prick! Come here! Good!
They'll follow you obediently, sire. Like minions. You can always kill them.
Right. Well, I can't think of anything else to do. So, can I go back? Can I go home? No. Can't go home. So, what do I do now? Do I try to get past these chaps? Can I dominate these chaps here? Oh, we actually have to kill some of them.
Your own human shield master if you subdue the peasants rather than killing them. Just don't channel your evil prison spell for so long.
Fair enough. Right, well, that's done. Let's go back. Let's see what's going on in our new home in the Netherworld. It's one thing I also like. We don't live in a tower in the middle of nowhere. Nope, we literally live in hell this time. The minions have clearly become a bit more of a serious problem. We don't live in a wasteland. We live in fucking hell. Literally demons in this game. Literally demons. With much fancier digs.
The Netherworld has accepted you as its master. Oh, I knew it!
Do calm down, Quaver. We don't want another accident. You are indeed our true overlord. It's somewhat of a relief, sire. We didn't want to have to bury another candidate.
How long have you been doing this?
Master! The Netherworld will be your new seat of power, Lord. It's a little on the cavernous side at the moment, but now you're properly here, we can start to refurbish and expand the tunnel system. This will allow us access to other areas of the world where you can establish your new dark domain. I feel a small poem is called for to commemorate the event. Oh dear, he's off again. There was a boy from the Nordberg town who sent the locals screaming. But now the boy's become a man. He'll start his evil scheming.
Can I kill him? Or is he...
Sorry about that, sire. Sometimes there's no stopping him. Believe me, I've tried. This is your throne, sire. And it's not just a place to rest your evil posterior. You can teleport around your domain from here. And it will also alert you about recent events and quests. Why don't you try it out? And then let me know if you'd like to take the tour.
Ah, yes. One thing that always entertained me is the fact you can actually fucking sit down in this game. We have ourselves a little map here.
Upside down, but it's all yours, sire.
Various quests. We can select here. Nordberg, request an audience, learn more about the foundations, blah, 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 blah. Let's go through the tutorial. It's been several years since I played this, so might as well.
Which area would you like to inspect, sire? Perhaps the minion burrows?
Yeah, sure.
Very good. Follow me, master.
I mean, you guys wouldn't shut the fuck up about the minion burrows and when I was a child, so might as well have a look at it. On my floating fucking platform! I mean, how would you travel around hell, eh? Floating platforms, the only way to go.
The minion burrows are believed to be the birthplace of the first minion. He who dug his way to the surface to serve the very first overlord. After we lost our last master, and before the great cataclysm decimated the old lands, we retreated here in the Exodus. Here we've remained.
Hand wave, explain.
Bastion of evil. Minion Mortis is in charge. That is to say, he facilitates your decisions, sire. Spawns new minions, tends the souls of the dead, make sure they don't come back with the wrong head, that sort of thing.
Minions, we live, we serve, we die. It is what we are, and what we will always be.
It's good that there's more than just the one minion that can actually speak in full sentences.
The spawning. You bring me life force, I bring you.
The barracks are where minions live when they're not out causing chaos with you, sire. It's also where we keep the hives, which allow minion summoning. Unfortunately, during the Exodus, several minion hives were lost. We only managed to retain the Browns. I'm sure they'd love a visit.
Ah, yes. Here you can't literally, as I believe I said, you can't literally go through them and see all of them. And I believe, if I recall correctly, as you can see there, I think the little title underneath is based on what they're equipped with. We got a lot of hunter herders. We got hunter hackers as well. Slightly different weapons. And then, of course, you have your fucking newborns, who are quite literally just your generic dudes. You can go through them. I don't think you can really do anything other than look at them from that thing. There is another part. I don't know where it is.
There are still more minion upgrades to collect, sire.
Yes, I'm aware. But yeah, I like the minion burrows when I played through this game the first time. I mean, there's not much to really do here, but it's just a fun thing to look around. Ah, this is where the red minions would be.
The Reds. He used to let them roast rats on his scythe. They were lured away by wisps, daft creatures. But we believe they're living in a volcanic area nearby.
Oh, well, how are they going to be living under the goddamn water, aren't they? So that'd be a vaguely interesting place to find them. down here, I think, as the, well, around here is where we should be finding the blue minion stuff. What the fuck is this?
These are dark crystals. Pure evil energy that's become crystallized.
And you fuckers didn't think I'd want those down here.
And very rare, sire. You may find them useful.
Very powerful, very rare. Also just sitting around downstairs.
Dead minion, sire.
This is the graveyard. You can view your recently deceased minions in the temple and resurrect your favorites.
But life has a price. Life or death. Death or life.
Indeed, Mortis. If you wish to resurrect a fallen minion, you need to sacrifice minions of the same color.
Yep, this is one thing you can't. This is, as I said before, you can't resurrect them. Also, notice how Mortis is an explicitly blue minion, even though apparently we don't have any of them. One thing that's always slightly bugged me is what... Then again, he, actually, having said that, he is also intelligent. So I suppose that makes sense. Yeah, stupid thing to complain about, actually, because they are the only intelligent... He is one of the rare intelligent minions, so he probably wouldn't get distracted and fuck off like the rest of the blue minions did. He'd actually have enough fucking intelligence to hang about when the rest of the minions pissed off to whatever the fuck the blue minions are. Oh, dear. Right, let's go through the other bits of the tour. Please don't do that weird jump again. There's no reason to jump.
We're a little bit flexible here in the netherworld.
Well, it is hell.
Step onto the rock, sire. It's probably safe. I mean, perfectly safe.
Filling me with confidence there now. Filling me with confidence. Go to the throne room interface again. I know this is basically just a very slight addition, a very slight change. It's kind of basically just slapping something over a menu screen, but god damn it, it's entertaining. Let's go to the foundations.
Maybe you'd like to inspect the Netherworld foundations, Master.
The notion that the Netherworld has foundations is a bit strange,
but... Master.
Sure. I mean, we're a... tower hanging from the ceiling, wouldn't we? Oh, it is actually going up, so I was correct. The foundations are at the top. Don't ask Quaver to sing you a lullaby. I don't want Quaver to exist, I'm gonna be honest with you.
Greetings, sire. Welcome to foundations. Master can hold up big netherworld buildings here.
Oh, can I, indeed?
Giblet is a particularly robust minion, sire. Been around almost as long as I have.
Giblet was in Overlord 1, wasn't it? That's unfortunate.
Ready to receive orders.
Oh, and there was another one of those dark, those evil energy crystals just fucking hanging out inside the Netherworld. I mean, granted, they probably would be in the Netherworld.
Let's forge something, Master.
Can't. Why do we need reds to power this thing? This thing's clearly working. Ah, well.
Giblet, ready to forge.
But, yes, this is where you can make shit. Oh, and I can upgrade my tower. I mean, I can't upgrade my tower, obviously, but this is where I can upgrade my tower if I wish to. If I am able to. Where my weapons and armor will be kept. There's actually DLC for this game that never made it to,
Look at least, then select to tell Giblet what you wish to build.
There's a DLC for this game that never actually came out for the PC, which was basically just the same. It was, as far as I could tell, was basically the arena from Overlord 1 again. Kind of sucks, because you could use the arena in Overlord 1 as a way to basically farm essence. And it was always or even farm equipment from certain kinds of enemies. It's always vaguely entertaining, that. Right, one more quest, and then I believe we will call it a video. My throat's killing me, so I think I'll call it a fucking day of recording.
Just let me know if your throne isn't comfy enough, sir.
I don't care about cushions. I don't need cushions where I'm going. I hope someone in this game tells me to go to hell. That would just... I don't know, that would tickle me. Go to hell. I live there. Deal with it.
I think the private quarters deserves your evil eye, Dark Lord.
I'm barely human and don't sleep. I don't even know why I have private quarters.
Follow me, Master.
Oh, it's right up there near the foundations, isn't it? Good.
This cavern will be your private quarters, Master. It is traditional in overlording circles to find oneself a mistress, or several. Keep an eye out for a suitable candidate. You know, something to make the room look pretty and to waft about the place. I'm quite partial to a bit of wafting.
It's weird how the mistresses appear to be a hell of a lot more for the actual minions than for the actual overlord. Okay, so function. Is that another fucking evil energy crystal just fucking hanging around? Stop it. Can we have people actually sweep the netherworld for this shit so I don't have to try and collect all?
This is your magic room, sire. By collecting spellstones and catalysts, you can expand your magical powers.
Oh, actually, a use
magic
for this room.
Is clean carnage, sire. No wear and tear on your weapons. Not so many entrails lodged in your armor. Now, don't neglect your magic.
Of course not. Magic's... I'm a magical creature. Magic is fundamental to my existence. It is required. Can I get down it? Okay, good. Right, so, if I recall correctly, we have just covered everything in the tutorial, and the next thing will be actually getting back down into Nordberg for a bit of a... bit of violence, a bit of the owl ultra-violence. So I'm just genuinely suspicious that there's just going to be like a bunch of the fucking crystals just hanging around here. I don't trust this game. Okay, there's like a little fucking path down here. No, my luck, there's going to be one of them down here somewhere. Other than that, I'm going mad. Also, the fact that there's bits of wood sticking out of the stone is slightly strange to me. Just a bit curious. Just a bit curious. Yes, salute. Good. Obey. Good. 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 There's another fucking path down here. I mean, I can't walk down there, but there's other paths and shit. I mean, you can kind of tell that this place is supposed to have had, the arena in it.
Minions are very excited to have you here, Lord.
Oh, good for them. Right, well, again, I didn't mean to go for over half an hour again, but I've gone for over half an hour, so, that's gonna have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Sardis Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a really shitty day when I recorded that. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. Anyway, just here to say that I have a Twitter account that you can follow if you want occasional updates of random thoughts from me, and that if you're feeling generous, feel free to donate to my Patreon campaign. Every penny donated there makes life easier for me generally and slowly goes towards me getting a better gaming PC. Well, that's that. It's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the Sideways Thinker. Do not seek the Pardoner.